Good wishes to all of you. Social Science, Resources and Developments, Textbook in Geography for Class 8, 5th Chapter, Industries, Audiobook. Journey begins. Paper made, recycle. Activity. Trace the journey of your shirt from your cotton field to your whiteboard. Have you ever given a thought to the fact that the notebook you use for writing has come to you after a long process of manufacturing? It started its life as part of a tree. It was cut down and transported to the pulp mill. There the wood of the tree was processed and converted into wood pulp. The wood pulp was mixed with chemicals and finally changed into papers by machines. This paper found its way to the press, where ink made from chemicals was used to print the lines on the pages. The pages were then bound in the form of a notebook, packed and sent to the market for sale. Finally, it reached your hands. Secondary activities or manufacturing change raw materials into products of more value to people. As you have seen, pulp was changed into paper and paper into a notebook. These represent the two stages of the manufacturing process. The paper made from pulp and cloth made from cotton have had value added to them at each stage of the manufacturing process. In this way, the finished product has more value and utility than the raw material that it is made from. Industry refers to an economic activity that is concerned with production of goods, extraction of minerals or the provision of services. Thus, we have iron and steel industry, production of goods, coal mining industry, extraction of coal, and tourism industry, service provider. Classification of industries. Industries can be classified on the basis of raw materials, size, and ownership. Raw materials industries may be agro-based, mineral-based, marine-based, and forest-based, depending on the type of raw materials they use. Agro-based industries use plant and animal-based products as their raw materials. Food processing, vegetable oil, cotton textile, dairy products, and leather industries are examples of agro-based industries. Mineral-based industries are primary industries that use mineral ores as their raw materials. The products of these industries feed other industries. Iron made from iron ore is the product of mineral-based industry. This is used as raw material for the manufacture of the number of other products, such as heavy machinery, building materials, and railway coaches. Marine-based industries use products from the sea and oceans as raw materials. Industries processing seafood or manufacturing fish oil are some examples. Forest-based industries utilize forest produce as raw materials. The industries associated with forests are pulp and paper, pharmaceuticals, furniture, and buildings. Activity. Give some examples of agro-based industries. Take a look at figure 5.1, stages in food processing of gargoyle nut makhana. Size. It refers to the amount of capital invested, number of people employed, and the volume of production based on size. Industries can be classified into small-scale and large-scale industries. Cottage or household industries are a type of small-scale industry where the products are manufactured by hand by the artisans. Basket weaving, pottery, and other handicrafts are examples of cottage industry. Small scale industries use lesser amount of capital and technology as compared to large scale industries that produce large volumes of products. Investment of capital is higher and the technology used is superior in large scale industries. Silk weaving and food processing industries are small-scale industries. Take a look at figure 5.1. Production of automobiles and heavy machinery are large-scale industries. Ownership. Industries can be classified into private sector, state owned or public sector, joint sector and cooperative sector. Private sector industries are owned and operated by individuals or a group of individuals. The public sector industries are owned and operated by the government, such as Hindustan Aeronautics Limited and Steel Authority of India Limited. Joint sector industries are owned and operated by the state and individual or a group of individuals. Maruti Udyog Limited is an example of joint sector industry. Cooperative sector industries are owned and operated by the producers or suppliers of raw materials, workers or both. Anand Milk Union Limited and Sudha Dairy are the success stories of a cooperative venture. Take a look at figure 5.2, Sudha Dairy in cooperative sector. Take a look at figure 5.3, locational factors for industries. Transport, land, power, raw material, labor, capital, market. Activity: find out the inputs, outputs and processes involved in the manufacture of a leather shoe. Factors affecting location of industries. The factors affecting the location of industries are the availability of raw material, land, water, labor, power, capital, transport and market. Industries are situated where some or all of these factors are easily available. Sometimes the government provides incentives like subsidized power, lower transport cost and other infrastructure so that industries may be located in backward areas. Industrialization often leads to development and growth of towns and cities. Industrial system. An industrial system consists of inputs, processes and outputs. The inputs are the raw materials, labor and costs of land, transport, power and other infrastructure. The processes include a wide range of activities that convert the raw material into finished products. The outputs are the end product and the income earned from it. In case of the textile industry, the inputs may be cotton, human labor, factory and transport cost. The processes include ginning, spinning, weaving, dyeing and printing. The output is the shirtwear. Industrial regions. Industrial regions emerge when a number of industries locate close to each other and share the benefits of their closeness. Major industrial regions of the world are Eastern North America, Western and Central Europe, Eastern Europe and Eastern Asia. Take a look at figure 5.4. Major industrial regions tend to be located in the temperature areas near seaports and especially near coal fields. India has several industrial regions like Mumbai, Pune cluster, Bangalore, Tamil Nadu region, Hooghly region, Ahmedabad, Baroda region, Chota Nagpur industrial belt, Visakhapatnam Guntur belt, Gurgaon, Delhi, Meerut region and the Kollam Thiruvananthapuram industrial cluster. Take a look at figure 5.4, world's industrial regions. Industrial disasters. Union Carbide factory. In industries, accidents, disasters mainly occur due to technical failure or irresponsible handling of hazardous material. One of the worst industrial disasters of all time occurred in Bhopal on 3rd December 1984 around 30 a.m. It was a technical accident in which highly poisonous methyl isocyanate MIC gas along with hydrogen cyanide and other reaction products leaked out of the pesticide factory of Union Carbide. The official death toll was 3,598 in 1989. Thousands who survived still suffer from one or many ailments like blindness, impaired immune system, gastrointestinal disorders, etc. In other incident, on 23rd December 2005, due to gas well blowout in Gaokila, Chongqing, China, 243 people died, 9,000 were injured and 64,000 were evacuated. Many people died because they were unable to run after the explosion. Those who could not escape in time suffered burns to their eyes, skin and lungs from the gas. Risk reduction measures. Rescue operation in Gaokila. Risk reduction measures. Densely populated residential areas should be separated far away from the industrial areas. People staying in the vicinity of industries should be aware of the strong storage of toxins or hazardous substances and their possible effects in case if an accident occurs. Fire warning and fighting system should be improved. Storage capacity of toxic substances should be limited. Pollution dispersion qualities in the industry should be improved. Do you know? Emerging industries are also known as sunrise industries. These include information technology, wellness, hospitality, and knowledge. Glossary. Smelting. It is the process in which metals are extracted from their ores by heating beyond the melting point. Distribution of major industries. The world's major industries are the iron and steel industry, the textile industry, and the information technology industry. The iron and steel and textile industry are the older industries, while information technology is an emerging industry. The countries in which iron and steel industry is located are Germany, USA, China, Japan, and Russia. Textile industry is concentrated in India, Hong Kong, South Korea, Japan, and Taiwan. The major hubs of information technology industry are the Silicon Valley of Central California and the Bangalore region of India. Iron and steel industry. Like other industries, iron and steel industry too comprises various inputs, processes, and outputs. This is a feeder industry whose products are used as raw material for other industries. The inputs for the industry include raw materials such as iron ore, coal, and limestone, along with the labor capital, site, and other infrastructure. The process of converting iron ore into steel involves many stages. The raw material is put in the blast furnace where it undergoes smelting. Take a look at figure 5.6. It is then refined. The output obtained is steel, which may be used by other industries as raw material. Take a look at figure 5.5, manufacturing of steel. 8 tons of coal plus 4 tons of iron ore plus 1 ton of limestone is equal to 1 ton of steel. Take a look at figure 5.6, from iron ore to steel in a blast furnace. Iron ore, limestone and coke, blast furnace, hot air, molten iron, slag. Take a look at figure 5.7, the changing location of the iron and steel industry. 1. The best location before 1800. 2. The best location from 1800 to 1950. 3. The best location since 1950. Steel is tough and it can easily be shaped, cut or made into wire. Special alloys of steel can be made by adding small amounts of other metals such as aluminium, nickel and copper. Alloys give steel unusual hardness, toughness or ability to resist rust. Steel is often called the backbone of modern industry. Almost everything we use is either made of iron or steel or has been made with tools and machinery of these metals. Ships, trains, trucks and autos are made largely of steel. Even the safety pins and the needles you use are made from steel. Oil wells are drilling with steel machinery. Steel pipelines transport oil. Minerals are mined with steel equipment. Farm machines are mostly steel. Large buildings have steel framework. Before 1800 Anno Domini, iron and steel industry was located where raw materials, power supply and running water were easily available. Later, the ideal location for the industry was near coal fields and close to canals and railways. After 1950, iron and steel industry began to be located on large areas of flat land near seaports. This is because by this time steelworks had become very large and iron ore had to be imported from overseas. Take a look at figure 5.7. In India, iron and steel industry has developed taking advantage of raw materials. Cheap labor, transport and market. All the important steel producing centers such as Bhilai, Durgapur, Burnpur, Jamshedpur, Rourkela, Bokhara are situated in a region that spreads over four states, West Bengal, Jharkhand, Odisha and Chhattisgarh, Bhadravati and Vijayanagara in Karnataka, Visakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh, Salem in Tamil Nadu are other important steel centers utilizing local resources. Take a look at figure 5.8 volt major iron ore producing areas. Jamshedpur. Before 1947, there was only one iron and steel plant in the country, Tata Iron and Steel Company Limited, TISCO. It was privately owned. After independence, the government took the initiative and set up several iron and steel plants. TISCO was started in 1907 at Sakchi, near the confluence of the rivers Subarnarekha and Karkhai in Jharkhand. Later on, Sakchi was renamed as Jamshedpur. Geographically, Jamshedpur is the most convenient situated iron and steel center in the country. Take a look at figure 5.9, location of iron and steel industry in Jamshedpur. Let's do, with the help of an atlas, identify some iron and steel industries in India and mark their location on an outline map of India. Reference, Major Road, Railway Line. Sakchi was chosen to set up the steel plant for several reasons. This place was only 32 kilometers away from Kalimati station on the Bengal-Nagpur Railway Line. It was close to the iron ore, coal and manganese deposits as well as to Kolkata, which provided a large market. TISCO gets coal from Jharia coal fields and iron ore, limestone, dolomite and manganese from Odisha and Chhattisgarh. The Karkai and Subarnarekha rivers ensured sufficient water supply. Government initiatives provided adequate capital for its later development. In Jamshedpur, several other industrial plants were set up after TISCO. They produced chemicals, locomotive parts, agriculture equipment, machinery, tin plate, cable and wire. The development of the iron and steel industry opened the doors to rapid industrial development in India. Almost all sectors of the Indian industry depended heavily on the iron and steel industry for their basic infrastructure. The Indian iron and steel industry consists of large integrated steel plants as well as many steel mills. It also includes secondary producers, rolling mills and ancillary industries. Do you know the names of Great Lakes are Superior, Huron, Ontario, Michigan and Erie? Lake Superior is the largest of these five lakes. It lies higher upstream than others. Ad Vocem. The term textile is derived from the Latin word textri, which means to weave. Pittsburgh. It is an important steel city of the United States of America. The steel industry at Pittsburgh enjoys locational advantages. Some of the raw materials such as coal is available locally, while the iron ore comes from the iron mines at Minnesota, about 1500 kilometers from Pittsburgh. Between these mines and Pittsburgh is one of the world's best routes for shipping Old Shipley, the famous Great Lakes waterway, trains carry the ore from the Great Lakes to the Pittsburgh area. The Ohio, the Monongahela and Allegheny rivers provide adequate water supply. Today, very few of the large steel mills are in Pittsburgh itself. They are located in the valleys of the Monongahela and Allegheny rivers above Pittsburgh and along the Ohio River below it. Finished steel is transported to the market by both land and water routes. The Pittsburgh area has many factories other than steel mills. This use steel as their raw material to make many different products such as railroad equipment, heavy machinery and rails. Cotton textile industry. Weaving cloth from yarn is an ancient art. Cotton, wool, silk, jute, flax have been used for making cloth. The textile industry can be divided on the basis of raw materials used in them. Fibers are the raw material of textile industry. Fibers can be natural or man-made. Natural fibers are obtained from wool, silk, cotton, linen, and jute. Man-made fibers include nylon, polyester, acrylic, and rayon. The cotton textile industry is one of the oldest industries in the world. Till the Industrial Revolution in the 18th century, cotton cloth was made using hand spinning techniques, wheels, and looms. In the 18th century, power looms facilitated the development of cotton textile industry, first in Britain and later in other parts of the world. Today, India, China, Japan, and the USA are important producers of cotton textiles. India has a glorious tradition of producing excellent quality cotton textiles. Before the British rule, India hand spun and hand woven cloth already had a wide market. The muslins of Dhaka, chinches of Machilipatnam, calicos of Calicut and gold rod cotton of Burhanpur, Surat and Vadodara were known worldwide for their quality and design, but the production of hand-woven cotton textile was expensive and time-consuming. Hence, traditional cotton textile industry could not face the competition from the new textile mills of the West, which produced cheap and good quality fabrics through mechanized industrial units. The first successful mechanized textile mill was established in Mumbai in 1854. The warm, moist climate, a port for importing machinery, availability of raw material and skilled labor resulted in rapid expansion of the industry in the region. Take a look at figure 5.10, World Major Cotton Textile Manufacturing Regions. Do you know the first textile mill in the country was established at Fort Gloucester near Kolkata in 1818, but it closed down after some time. Initially, this industry flourished in the states of Maharashtra and Gujarat because of favorable humid climate, but today humidity can be created artificially and raw cotton is a pure and not weight-loss raw materials. So this industry has spread to other parts of India. Coimbatore, Kanpur, Chennai, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Kolkata, Ludhiana, Puducherry and Panipat are some of the other important centers. Ahmedabad, it is located in Gujarat on the banks of the Sabarmati River. The first mill was established in 1859. It soon became the second largest textile city of India. After Mumbai, Ahmedabad was therefore often referred to as the Manchester of India. Favorable locational factors were responsible for the development of the textile industry in Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad is situated very close to cotton growing area. This ensures easy availability of raw material. The climate is ideal for spinning and weaving. The flat terrain and easy availability of land is suitable for the establishment of the mills. The densely populated states of Gujarat and Maharashtra provide both skilled and semi-skilled labor. Well-developed road and railway network permits easy transportation of textiles to different parts of the country, thus providing easy access to the market. Mumbai port nearby facilitates import of machinery and export of cotton textiles. But in the recent years, Ahmedabad textile mills have been having some problems. Several textile mills have closed down. This is primarily due to the emergence of new textile centers in the country as well as non-upgradation of machines and technology in the mills of Ahmedabad. Activity: collect different types of pieces of cloth from a tailor shop and classify them under cotton, silk, synthetic and woolen. Find out the raw materials used in their manufacturing. Let's do on an outline map of the world. Mark the places which provide raw material to cotton textile industry of Osaka. Osaka, it is an important textile center of Japan, also known as the Manchester of Japan. The textile industry developed in Osaka due to several geographical factors. The extensive plain around Osaka ensured that land was easily available for the growth of cotton mills. Warm, humid climate is well suited to spinning and weaving. The river Yodo provides sufficient water for the mills. Labor is easily available. Location of port facilities, import of raw cotton and for exporting textiles. The textile industry at Osaka depends completely upon imported raw materials. Cotton is imported from Egypt, India, China and USA. The finished product is mostly exported and has a good market due to good quality and low price. Though it is one of the important textile cities in the country, of late the cotton textile industry of Osaka has been replaced by other industries such as iron and steel, machinery, shipbuilding, automobiles, electrical equipment and cement. Exercises. Answer the following questions. What is meant by the term industry? Which are the main factors which influence the location of an industry? Which industry is often referred to as the backbone of modern industry and why? Why cotton textile industry rapidly expanded in Mumbai? Take the correct answer. Fort Gloucester is located in West Bengal, California, Gujarat. Which one of the following is a natural fiber? Nylon, jute, acrylic. Distinguish between the followings: agro-based and mineral-based industry, public sector and joint sector industry. Give two examples of the following in the space provided: raw materials dash and dash, end products dash and dash, territory activities dash and dash, agro-based industries dash and dash, cottage industries dash and dash, cooperatives dash and dash. Activity: how to identify a location for establishing an industry. Divide your class into groups. Each group is a board of directors faced with the problem of choosing a suitable site for an iron and steel plant of development dweep. A team of technical experts has submitted a report with notes and a map. The team consulted access to iron ore, coal, water and limestone, as well as the main market sources of labor and port facilities. The team has suggested two sites, X and Y. The board of directors has to take the final decision about where to locate the steel plant. Read the report submitted by the team. Study the map to find out the distances of the resources from each site. Give each resource a weight from 1 to 10 according to its importance. The greater the pull of the factor on the industry, the higher the weight from 1 to 10. Complete the table on the next page. The site with the lowest total should be the most satisfactory site. Remember, each group of directions can decide differently. Report. Factors, resources affecting the location of a proposed iron and steel plant on development dweep. Iron ore. This is a very large deposit of low-grade iron ore. Long-distance transportation of the ore would be uneconomic. Coal. The only coal-fired contains rich deposits of high-grade coal. Transportation of the coal is by railway, which is relatively cheap. Limestone. This is widely available over the island, but the purest deposits are in the Chuna Mountains water. Both the tributaries of River Nile carry sufficient water to supply a large iron and steel plant in all seasons. The seawater, because of its high salt content, is unsuitable market. It is expected that the chief market for the plant's products will be the engineering works of Rajdhanipur. Transport costs for the products, mainly small steel bars and light steel plates, would be relatively low. Labor supply. This will have to be recruited mainly from the unskilled workers in the three fishing villages of Hill, Rah and Singh. It is expected that most workers will commute daily from their present homes. Port facilities. These are at the present minimal. There is a good deep natural harbour at Port Pashimpur, developed to import metal alloys. Resources. Distance from X, distance from Y, weighting 1 to 10, distance X weight for site X, distance X weight for site Y. Iron ore, coal, limestone, water, chief market, labor supply, total is equal. The larger the pool, the higher the weighting. Thank you.